Good evening, our beloved viewers. Mm-hmm. Welcome again to Global Strong Broadcast. Mm-hmm. This is Mr. and Mrs. Pastor Monene.
Amen.
And we are so glad,
yes,
that once again the Lord has given us an opportunity,
yes,
to share the word of God.
Praise
with
God.
You. To God be all the glory.
Amen.
We are so glad that the Lord has kept us well.
Yes.
I know there has been a lot of challenges, mm, happening up and down.
Oh, yes.
But the grace of God,
the grace of God is sufficient.
Has been sufficient.
Amen.
And the Bible says that to them that are among the living,
yes,
there is still
hope.
There is still hope.
Amen.
And seeing that you are alive,
yes,
it tells you that God loves you.
God loves you.
Even though things are not the way you may want them to be,
yes,
probably maybe you are low in finances,
mm-hmm,
your health may not be very good, things are a little bit challenging.
Yes.
As long as you are alive,
mm,
there is hope for
there
you.
There is hope for you.
And tonight, we have no doubt,
amen,
that the word of God will come once again,
amen,
with the power,
amen,
with the liberation.
Praise the Lord.
And that God will speak to his people,
amen,
like he has done there before,
amen,
in Jesus' wonderful
in
name.
Jesus' wonderful name.
We are so grateful to see the many people who are joining right now.
Amen.
And we want to ask you, as we go to prayer,
mm-hmm,
you connect with other people,
yes,
you share the broadcast.
Mm-hmm.
Please tell your friends,
yes,
to a tour they are on.
Mm. Yes.
Very, very important.
Amen.
Share this broadcast.
Praise the Lord.
It's gonna be hot. Today is Friday.
Today is Friday.
You know, and we are talking about godly sex.
Today we are talking about godly sex.
Yeah.
That means there is the worldly sex.
And there is the godly sex.
The godly sex.
So you're talking about godly sex. Because you see, mm, sex has got its originator.
Yes.
And you want to know today, mm, what was the plan of God,
amen,
when he was coming up with sex?
Oh, yes.
Because there was the plan of God,
amen,
when he was coming up with this beautiful game.
Amen.
You remember my wife, when the creep went viral,
mm-hmm,
the creep was very clear.
Yes.
And you know, she was talking about, you know, sex is the only game,
mm,
that God
created.
That God created.
Yes.
That God made.
Mm.
Then we said all the others,
mm,
are man-made. I like that.
Yes.
You know, and that's very, very key.
Mm.
That sex is the only game,
oh, yes,
that God created. All the others are man-made. Think about it.
Think about it.
Football?
Man-made.
Volleyball?
Man-made.
Swimming?
Man-made.
Car racing?
Man-made.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all these games,
yes,
are created, are made,
yes,
by men.
Yes.
But the only game that God created, that does not, you know, have issues of time,
yes,
season,
uh-huh,
you know,
yeah,
this one does not have the issue of, you know, time,
mm-hmm,
season, whether it's raining or not,
yes,
whether it is day or night,
yes,
you
as
can,
long as you're married,
as long as you're married,
your husband,
you can enjoy it.
Yes.
Can you imagine?
Amen.
There are times that we can't do swimming,
mm,
especially when it's raining,
mm,
we don't want to go to the water.
Mm-hmm.
Not all the times we can do football.
Yes.
You know? But when they come to the game of God,
yes,
imagine it has no season.
It has no season.
It has no time.
Amen.
Limit.
Amen.
You know?
Yes.
Football, we have limits.
We have limits.
You know? But the game of God is one of the best things that we can have.
We're going to discuss it.
So
today,
we're going to talk about godly, mm, sex and the lessons that we are going to learn,
mm,
from, you know, this game of God.
Amen.
But before we do that, can we make a short prayer in, mm, Jesus' name?
Amen.
Our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus,
yes, Lord,
I want to thank you because of every viewer tonight.
Yes, Lord.
And even this morning,
mm,
regardless of the distance,
mm,
regardless of where we are,
mm,
right from the city of Nairobi,
mm,
we speak the peace of God.
We speak the peace
we
of God.
We speak the joy of the Lord.
We speak the joy of the Lord.
And at the end of this broadcast,
yes,
may your marriage,
amen,
become better.
Hallelujah.
May your relationship,
amen,
become better.
Praise the Lord.
We pray that God, we are going to speak to millions of people.
Hallelujah.
Through this broadcast tonight.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And so today we are talking about godly sex.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to begin by saying that sex was not invented by the media.
Wonderful.
You know, that's a very important thing.
Mm.
That sex was not invented by any TV station.
Yes.
By any radio station.
Mm-hmm.
It was not invented by
social media.
Social media.
Mm-hmm. Scientists.
You know,
mm-hmm.
and all that.
Yes.
And it's therefore very, very important we ask ourselves, who invented sex?
Who invented sex?
What was his mind?
What was his mind?
When he invented sex.
Amen.
And you know what? When people who never invented something, they begin talking about it, sometimes they can make mistakes.
Amen.
Sometimes they can get it wrong.
Yes.
And you know, we've got all the stories in the media about the sex.
About sex.
You know, about Tua. Let's call it actually Tua.
Yes.
When you listen to the media, there's a lot of corruption.
Corruption.
There's a lot of you know, funny things that they talk about.
Very true.
When it comes to Tua. And if we are not careful, we can borrow what goes on out there in the media.
Yes.
And we think that was the mind of God. Concerning Tua,
concerning sex.
Yeah, but for sure, that is not the mind of God.
Praise the Lord.
If we want to get it correct,
yes.
If you want to get it right, we must consult the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
Because the originator
of sex
is God Himself.
God Almighty.
The creator of sex,
yes.
It is God Himself.
It is God Himself.
Therefore, if we're gonna get it correct and right,
yes,
then
Pastor.
We're gonna ask God, what did He mean when He was creating this game? I want to let you know that you know God has got the best plan.
Amen.
When it comes to Tua.
Very.
Actually, if there's one with the best plan, it is God
it
Himself.
It is God Himself.
He has got the best plan. So if you're not enjoying Tua
in marriage,
there must be a challenge somewhere. There must be a problem somewhere.
Either you don't have the accurate knowledge.
The accurate knowledge.
Yeah, on how Tua is done. Or you have a distorted mindset.
Exactly.
You know, depending with your entry to sex. You know, some of us probably we knew sex when we were not born again. And so the way we were introduced to sex distorted our mindset. So the entry door to sex can also mess somebody's perspective towards sex. And that's why you find the enemy, the devil has succeeded to make sure that the believers, the born again people, are shy to talk about sex. Even between a husband and a wife,
they are shy.
They are shy to speak about sex, whether they are satisfied, whether there's something they can do to improve, because the enemy has made sure that he puts fear. We look at it as a taboo, as something that should not be discussed, even among a husband and a wife. And so there's a lot of guesswork. There's a lot of dissatisfaction even in marriage. There's a lot of dissatisfaction even among the people who are anticipating to marry, because there's no clear cut on what is expected on them sexually when they are married.
Exactly.
And so you find, since we who are married, we are not courageous to teach our youth on how to handle sexuality, they begin having sex even before marriage. And it has its own consequences.
Exactly.
And so it is important, Pastor, we speak this language so clearly, and we base our teaching on the Word of God. Because the Word of God is very clear about sex. God has not hidden any information about sex. It is actually stipulated in His Word.
Yes.
But when we don't study the Word of God and get to understand the mind of God concerning sex, then we are likely to borrow from the world. And you see, the standards of the world are distorted. Because now the world will tell you, having sex with a man, to a man, is sex. Having sex with a woman and you are a woman is sex. But see, that is distortion. You know, the world will tell
according
you having sex with an animal is okay, as long as you are enjoying sex.
Yeah.
But the originator, the original person who came out with sex is God, because He actually is the one who creates our sexual organs right in our mother's womb.
Exactly.
And so it is important for us to learn exactly what was the mind of God.
And by the way, I want to say, I some people can attest to this, even those who are married.
Yes.
That when you're going through the counseling,
yes,
the premarital counseling, probably maybe people who are helping you, they were not bold enough to tell you the real thing what happened.
Oh yes.
So when you got there, mm-hmm. ilikuwa mambo ya pata
potea. Yes. Pata potea.
I know you can identify mm-hmm. with that. Mm-hmm. There are people who got married, mm-hmm. but they are best couple. Mm-hmm. The people who are taking them through.
Oh yes.
They were not clear mm-hmm. on this matter.
Yeah.
And so when you got there, it was like mm-hmm. you're not even very sure.
Yes.
Where do you begin mm-hmm. and where do you end?
Oh yes.
And that's why I want to thank you, mm-hmm. my wife. Mm-hmm. Because you have helped so many young people
Amen.
Who are getting married.
Oh yes.
And maybe if you are there, you are listening mm. to us mm. and you are planning for a wedding.
Mm.
You are planning for a ceremony to mm. get married.
Mm.
That's why we are here.
Yes.
Call us.
Mm.
We can have a date.
Mm.
We can help you on some of those gray areas
oh, yes.
that probably people shy to talk mm. about.
Oh yes.
By the grace of God.
Mm.
That's why we are here.
Yes.
Don't shy away.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be good.
That will be good.
So since God is the originator of sex, mm. then mm-hmm. He is the only one who can tell us
yes.
how can we do this day.
Uh-huh.
And this morning, this evening, there's a scripture I would want to read,
mm.
and then we are going to learn lessons,
mm-hmm.
you know, from this scripture
mm-hmm.
and from what we're discussing today.
Yes.
We are going to have lessons
mm.
that we can learn from the Bible
mm-hmm.
about godly sex. Remember our teaching today
mm.
and our topic today,
mm.
it is godly sex.
Mm.
And so we are going to pick some lessons
mm.
that we can learn.
Yeah, because God has a plan.
Exactly.
And He has explained about sex in His word.
Exactly.
And so the Bible,
mm.
God is not afraid
exactly.
to speak about God's, you know, this game,
mm.
this holy game,
yes.
this sacred game
yes.
that God has given us. His word is very clear.
Exactly.
And so it's very important for us to get the lessons
mm.
that we need to get from His word.
Exactly. So what does the word of God say
mm-hmm.
concerning
mm.
sex
mm.
concerning tua.
Yes.
I'll read only two or three verses
mm.
and then from there
mm.
we will talk a few lessons.
Mm.
There are quite many,
mm.
but let's just talk about a few of them
mm.
and it's going to be good for the night
mm.
or for the day.
Mm.
I'm reading the book of 1 Corinthians
yes.
chapter 7
mm.
From verse 3
mm.
up to verse 5.
Mm.
I'll repeat it again. 1 Corinthians
mm.
chapter 7
yes.
and verse 3
mm-hmm.
all the way to 5.
Amen.
The word of God says,
mm-hmm.
The husband should fulfill his marital duty
mm-hmm.
to his wife.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. The Bible is very clear.
Yes.
The husband.
Yes.
So we are talking to who? The married.
Yes, to the married. The husband.
The husband.
All right. Yes.
The husband should fulfill
mm-hmm.
his marital
mm-hmm.
duty.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? His marital duty
mm-hmm.
to his wife.
Mm.
The Bible calls it
mm.
duty.
Yes.
Now, note that.
Yes, duty. That means there are times you will have sex.
Yes.
Even when you don't feel like.
It's
as long as.
Yes.
As long as your partner is in need.
Yes.
Of, you know, he has the need of sex.
Yes.
So the Bible mm. is talking about duty.
Yeah.
Just like the way we report on duty. Even when we don't feel like.
Yeah, there's sometimes you don't feel like.
You don't feel like going to work.
You don't want to go to work.
Even when it's your own business.
Yes.
You just feel you don't want to work.
Yes.
But because of the responsibility that
mm.
is upon you.
Mm.
We report on duty because
mm.
it's you are supposed to be on duty.
Yes.
So we also need to take the same mentality as the word of God says.
Yes.
That it is your personal responsibility.
Yes.
To make sure that yes. that duty in marriage, it is done effectively.
You know, I'm just thinking right now.
Yes.
If one day you woke up in the morning
uh-huh.
and you called your boss and you told him.
Yes.
Leo sijisiki kwenda kazi.
Uh-huh.
Or for the next 1 month.
Yes.
Sijisiki kwenda kazi.
Mm-hmm. You'll be fired. You'll be fired. Yeah.
You know.
Yes.
Very, very key. Eh?
Uh-huh.
All right. So we're saying here the husband should fulfill
mm-hmm.
his marital duty.
Amen.
To his wife.
Mm-hmm.
And likewise the wife.
Mm-hmm.
To her husband.
Wow.
So it's a two-way traffic.
Mm-hmm.
The husband is doing his part.
Yes.
And the wife also mm-hmm. is doing her part.
Yes. Why?
Mm-hmm.
Because this is the only game
yes.
which you cannot delegate.
Oh.
Yes.
It's the only
game
that you.
It's the only duty you cannot delegate. Sometimes when you are a teacher, you may tell your colleagues to stand in,
to stand in for you.
If you are a medical doctor and you are in the hospital and you are not available, you can tell your colleagues to stand in for you. Meanwhile, you are coming. But you see, when we talk about godly sex, this is not something you can delegate.
Yes.
You can't give it to your best friend.
Okay.
You can't tell your son or your daughter to do it. You can't tell a neighbor to do it. You can't tell your worker to do it.
Exactly.
This is something that you must personally do it.
Exactly.
And do it effectively and joyfully.
Wow. Now that's very...
That's powerful.
Powerful.
Very powerful.
But it's the only responsibility.
You cannot delegate.
You need to share this broadcast. Seriously, if you are married and you know there's a woman somewhere or a man somewhere who is married, whether in Kenya, whether in the UK, kindly share this broadcast now.